Hello everyone, today let us see the second part of the log file monitoring. Usually what happens in a log file is that we receive a variety of errors, but there are not many log files where we see the OK messages as well. So for example, if there is any error that is triggered, there may not be a scenario wherein it says the error has been resolved. But yes, there are logs wherein it also throws the error, as well as it says now it is back to normal. So we have to capture those kind of log files as well in the business environment. Let us see how we go about that. For that, let us create a template. Okay, let us give a name. Let's add it to a group, click on add. Okay. I guess I gave instead of shutdown, no problem. Let's go back. Let's go to application. Let's create an application called as logs. And let's go to items. Let us create new item. Here, shutdown error. Okay, most important thing is that the type should be Zabbix agent active, and then let's go to the key. We have to give as a log file of the word. Okay, this is going to be the file, the log file, and then we are going to give the word shutdown, put a pipe, and then use the word recovered. Or if you want to have more than one conditions, we can check it as it is. Rather than creating multiple items, we can use it this way. So for the simplicity, let's give it as 1 second. Okay. And the most important thing is that it has to be a log type of information. Otherwise, it's not going to capture. So let's click on logs. Click the enable. Click on active. Sorry, enable, and then click on add. Then let's go to triggers. Now let's create a trigger. Here, what is most important is that we are going to create two items, two expressions rather. So let's say error hyphen recovered. Okay, so let's give it as average. Here, let us click on add, and we have our item here. Okay, let's click on insert. The most important is that we're not going to use the word last. Instead, we are going to use str string, and of the word shutdown, that is whatever word we are a keyword we are using here, we have to use the same. Now let's copy this. Let us make this equal to 1. Control A, Control C. Let's give it a let's click on the recovery expression, put it here. So instead of shutdown, let's say recover. Okay, with this, we're gonna make sure that whenever the error keyword shutdown is appearing, and then later we receive a word called recover, it's gonna solve the alert automatically. Okay, it's not managed to click on allow manual flows, but it can help. Click on add. Now let us see how we go about it. Okay, let's click on this update. Now let's go to the host, and then let me click here, and then we're gonna deploy this. Sorry about that. Yep. Okay, so that's done. Next, what you're gonna do is you're gonna click on the problems page and see. Okay, there's no error. So you're gonna go to the log file. It's slash temp log, the file that we're gonna edit now. So I'm gonna put the word shutdown. Okay, let's just copy this and then click on insert. Say Okay, put a space, it doesn't matter whatever it is. Let's just click and then colon, save it, and yeah. So those is not the right word to be used. Okay, error hyphen recovered. So we have received the error. So it's a problem statement. It has been detected. Now let us use the word recover. Okay, so we're gonna use the same, and then instead of shutdown, let us use the word recovered. I'm gonna save it. Let's see, it's gonna convert from problem to resolved. Here we go, got resolved. So this is how it works usually. Thanks guys, more in the next. Cheers.